I just wanted to also add something. So oftentimes we read op-eds in the New York Times and the Washington Post, and if they're like obviously anti-us, you know. When people write their, you know, op-eds, then, or if I write an op-ed, they get letters to the editor, right? And the letters are things like, Linda Sarsour is an anti-Semitic, anti-Israel, radical Islamic supremacist, and she should not have a platform in the New York Times or the Washington Post. That's what they say, and they write those letters to the editor, and guess what the editor does? They oftentimes publish those letters to the editor. So what I want to say to the Muslims is this. We are so good at being disgruntled and angry about everything. Oh, he's an Islamophobe. Oh, we don't agree with her. Oh, and we sit in our couches and we sit on Facebook and we're mad about everything and we're such good complainers. Muslims need to get the highest award in the land for the best complainers about everything. But we don't want to do anything beyond the complaining. So if you read an op-ed, if you read something that you don't agree with, guess what you can do? Write a very short one paragraph, two paragraph letter to the editor expressing why you don't agree with what was written. And guess what's going to happen? You will get published. You may not always get published, but oftentimes you will get published. So you actually have power to put your voice somewhere where you don't agree. So being mad in your house on your couch with your friends is not helping the Muslim community, nor is it helping us to challenge the views that are out there. If that outlet does not want to publish your letter to the editor, then go to another outlet and write something in response to that. And I'm going to give you an example. A woman by the name of Emily Shire wrote an op-ed in the New York Times saying that there's no room for people like me in the feminist movement as someone who's a critic of Israel. And is there room for Zionist women in the feminist movement? She wrote that. I didn't write that. She started. I know I'm petty, I know. She started. But I was not going to allow her to be unchallenged, that she was going to talk about why we are talking about Palestinian human rights within the U.S. feminist movement. So the New York Times, they don't want to publish a letter to the editor, so I wanted to be bigger than a letter to the editor. We went to The Nation, right, which I know a lot of my progressive friends read, and I wanted to also talk to them. So I did a whole thing in The Nation in response to Emily Shire, which then made Emily Shire have to respond to me again. The reason why that's important is because we create a dialogue, and we show people that we are not afraid of them, we are not afraid to challenge views that are against our views, that we too are public intellectuals, that we too have arguments to make, that we too have positions to make. Do not allow others to make final position. You know how they say the last person gets the word? I want to be the last person to get the word in. And that's how we have to start operating as a Muslim community. We cannot let the Islamophobes get the last word on our communities, on our deen, on our organizations, on our leaders, on our campaigns. So if you leave here today with anything, Muslims need to get the last word.